What's up, everybody? I hope you're all having a great day. Thanks for returning for some more Fallout 3. I've got the 11th episode in the series for you today, and I hope you're ready for some more action in the wasteland. If you enjoy video game content of all kinds, make sure you leave a like and subscribe and turn on the notification bell so you won't miss any of my other uploads. Enjoy!
Some folks can lose the blues in their heart,
but when I think of you, another shower starts into each life. Some rain must fall, but too much is falling in mine.
Welcome to Vault 112, Resident. According to sensors, you have arrived 202.3 years behind schedule. Please redress in your Vault Tech issued vault suit before proceeding. If you have misplaced your suit, I am authorized to distribute a new one. Once dressed, please proceed down the stairs to the main floor so that you may enter your assigned Tranquility Lounger.
Everybody, this is Three Dog, your friendly neighborhood disc jockey. What's a disc? Hell if I know, but I'm gonna keep talking anyway. What rhymes with shoes and often gives you the blues? That's right, it's time for the cashews. Okay, that doesn't really rhyme. How about news? Good news, kids! Our old friend from Vault 101 is, get this, still alive.
Yes, sir.
Because there is a god. Here's your update on the Ranger of the Wastes. Ooh, boy! Children, you are going to love this. Okay, so I told you about James, the guy from the vault. And then I told you somebody else crawled out of there, too. Right. Well, guess who came to visit old Frida?
Hey there, sport. Beautiful day, isn't it? Say, you should go talk to Betty. She's waiting for you over on the playground. Have fun, sport.
Hiya, kiddo. What's the good word? Can't say that I have, kiddo. Don't worry. I'm sure he'll turn up. Yep, you've got that right. Heck of a day to get some work done outdoors. Nice place. Real nice. Everyone's friendly and always happy to lend a hand. Is that so? Well, you ought to tell that to my big toe, kiddo. Hurts like the dickens since I stubbed it earlier today. Feels pretty real to me. Bye-bye!
Play with. What good luck I have lately. I was just starting to get bored. Oh, we're going to have so much fun. I'm Betty. I live here on Tranquility Lane. Want to play a game? We're going to play a game now, silly. That's what's going on. I knew you would. It's a really simple game. All you have to do is make Timmy Newsbum cry. He's the only other kid that lives here besides you. He's a big crybaby. You'll see. Make him cry, and then come back here so we can talk some more.
Good day.
Well, hi there. That boy is trouble, if you ask me. Pat babies him like you wouldn't believe. Acts like he's still an infant. He's never out of his parents' sight. Can you imagine what it'll be like the first time he's separated from them? I don't think so, but then I haven't really been looking for him. Sorry. Sorry, kiddo, but I'm not in the mood for jokes. Bye-bye!
Hello!
Hi there, I'm Timmy. Wanna play? You're a big, dumb liar. Hi, wanna play? What? No, she didn't. Did she? I don't like her. She's creepy, and she laughs at stuff that isn't funny. Your dad? Nope, I haven't. Did he get lost? It's okay, I guess. I don't really have nobody to play with, except for Betty, and she's kind of, well, she's mean. What? You're weird. Bye-bye. Hi, George.
Hello there.
Ow! Stop! Ow! No, no!
It was nothing.
Ow! That hurt! Quit! That hurt! That hurt! Quit! Quit! That hurt! Ow! Stop! That hurt! Stop! Stop!
Thank you.
You sure showed him, didn't you?
I suppose it wasn't the most cerebral way to deal with the situation, but it was definitely effective. Consider the game won. And with that, you win a prize. Your prize is one question which I will answer to the best of my ability.
Your father? Oh my, what a splendid turn of events. I had no idea the two of you were related. Yes, I have indeed seen him. I'm afraid he's rather unavailable at the moment. Were I you, I'd be more concerned with myself at the moment.
And besides, we're done with questions for now. Perhaps we'll address it at a later time. First, I have something else for you to do. Pay a visit to the Rockwells. They're very happily married, and I'd like you to change that. Put an end to their marriage, and we'll talk. Rationalize it any way you'd like. If you succeed, we'll continue our discussion.
You can't do that here. And now you have to pay.
Hey there, sport. How's it going? Heck of a place to live. Janet and I, well, we're quite happy here. Sure, sport. Whatever you say. Hello!
Hello. Well, hi there. Necessary.
I'm out of here.
Good day. Good day. You don't belong here. You're not supposed to be here. It's not real, none of it. It needs to end. The suffering must end. We're not really here. We're not really talking. It's all made up, make believe.
We're sleeping, dreaming. The dream became a nightmare. It has to end. It just has to. But we're not in charge. He is. And he doesn't want us to wake up. He calls himself Betty now, but he's still the same. He can put on a new face all he likes, but underneath he's still evil. Braun. Bastard thinks because he helped create this place, he's God here. But I know he still uses the fail-safe terminal. I know it. Don't know. Can't sleep sometimes. Hear voices. My own skin doesn't feel right. None of this is right. You've got to believe me. You've got to find that failsafe. It's in the abandoned house. He doesn't want us going in there because he's afraid we might find it. It's the only terminal to the outside. The only way to shut the whole thing down. You've got to find it.
Well, hi there.
What?
No! No!
Good day.
No! No!
Watch where you're swinging that, will you?
Hello!
Well, hi there.
Hello. Henderson Estate is in tip-top shape, young master. Have a wonderful day.
Real.
Good day.
Good day.
Hello.
Hey there, sport, how's it going?
Good day to you. What were you doing in our basement? What's down there? Okay, if you say so. What's this? Women's clothing? Down here? What? What the hell is this? But this isn't mine. What is this doing here? Oh my God. Roger. He wouldn't. But hello. This has to end.
Well, hi there. Have a...
This has to end.
Good day. Oh, Mabel, did you want to look for a new robot? I know you're not comfortable with yours.
You sure showed him, didn't you?
I suppose it wasn't the most cerebral way to deal with the situation, but it was... And with that... Tranquility Lake, it was my... Isn't it obvious by now? You've only been here a short while, and you're already doing just as I ask. And now we come to your next game. Succeed, and there may be something in it for you. Pay a visit to the Rockwells. They're very happily put an end.
I don't even really want the one I have now. I don't trust it, Martha. Not a bit. You know, there's nothing to worry about, right? It's perfectly safe. They build them so they won't ever hurt their owners. Well, maybe you can. Good day. This has to end.
horrible thing.
Our Mabel did. What? Now that's a ridiculous. But.
Hello! Good day to you. Now see here. That's not anything for you to be asking about. Our marriage is our business and it's private. Why can't people just understand that and just leave us alone? Now that's not funny. Not one bit. Hello.
Hello.
Don't you have something you should be doing now?
If you insist on an answer, then you may better know me as Dr. Stanislaus Braun.
I've chosen a different appearance for myself here, in my own little playground. Visit the Rockwells, observe their happy marriage, and then destroy it. But don't kill them. That'd spoil the fun.
Good day to you. Well, they're just so nice, aren't they? It's good the two of them worked everything out. Oh, I'm not one to talk, but there was that fight last year. Everyone could hear them arguing. Janet thought there was something going on with Roger and Martha Simpson. He eventually convinced her it wasn't true. But I've seen the way Martha looks at him. Janet may believe him, but I sure don't. Tip? Good day to you. Why are you asking me? I don't know anything. And why should I care about their marriage anyway? There's no story. Never was. Roger and I, nothing ever happened. I wanted... Oh, I don't know. I thought there was something between us. No, that's not true. I know there was. But Roger pushed me away, tried to deny it. Even Janet knew it was there. She fought with him over it. I think she still suspects something. I try to stay away from Roger, just to avoid giving her a reason to hate me more. Hello. Well, hi there. Hello.
Well, hi there.
This has to end. This has to end. Good day to you. Hello.
Good day.
Good day. Mabel, I meant to ask you, have you seen the new Robco catalog? I thought you might be interested. Since you don't seem to like your Mr. Handy. I don't want a new one. I don't even really want the one I have now. I don't trust it, Martha. Not a bit. Good day to you. But... well...
good riddance!
Good day to you.
Is that really necessary?
Hello. Well, hi there. Take...
hey there, sport, how's it going? What? What are you talking about? But Janet would never... I mean, I know she was upset, but I thought she was over it. How could she do this? My God. Janet, what have you done?
What on earth are you talking about, Roger?
How could you? How could you do that to her? Have you lost your mind?
Roger, stop it. You're scaring me.
You should be in a sanitarium or a prison. You're out of your damn mind. You just stay away from me, you hear me?
Good day.
Quite a clever interpretation of the rules. I'll have to reset the system to restore Martha, but it's well worth the effort. You have taken a far greater interest in these little games than your father did. He found the whole thing beneath him. You have amused me thus far, but I still don't think you're quite in a position to be demanding anything. Still, I suppose you've earned the right to some further answers. What would you ask of me? Your father, frustrating as he was, recognized the significance of some of my previous work. He came to gather information on it. He was most pleased to be able to ask me directly, but he failed to understand how things work here. He was unwilling to compromise, to do anything I asked of him, and so our discussions ended.
Oh dear, now you don't even believe me. How disappointing.
I assure you, James and I talked at length before you arrived. Now let's continue before I grow bored with you. Oh, come now, show some enthusiasm.
There are fewer rules this time. I'd like to see just what you're capable of.
I'd like you to kill Mabel Henderson. Please put some effort into it. Do something creative. Beating her to death won't impress me.
Of course you will. And you never know, you might enjoy it.
Good day to you. Have a great day.
Good afternoon.
Good day. Well, hi there. Have a great day. Hello.
Good day to you, young master.
Well done, well done. You certainly do get results. You have exceeded my expectations.
And now, we come to the last task I have for you. Succeed, and you shall be granted whatever you wish. I think you'll find that I've been quite honest with you thus far. You have no discernible reason to mistrust me. In the doghouse, out behind the abandoned home, are a mask and knife. don the mask, and become the pint-sized slasher. Use the knife to eliminate all the residents of Tranquility Lane. He is a figure of myth, born of old campfire stories. You will make him a reality. The residents will know you and they will fear you. When they have all been eliminated, return to me. I am afraid you're not in a position to decide what they do or do not deserve. They are under my control, not yours. Now, if you're done attempting to change my mind, let's get on with your final task. After completing it, you will be free to go.
The pint-sized slasher! Someone help me! The pint-sized... Help! Help! No.
Run! It's the pint-sized slasher! Oh!
Hurrah!
Most enjoyable. Most enjoyable indeed. I haven't felt this exhilarated in years.
Yes, yes. I suppose you've earned the right to do as you like.
I shall miss your company. This has been a simply wonderful time.
The door is now open. Through it, you may return to the real world, and whatever inferior existence you have there.